Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to the final episode of Blackthorne. We are finally in Sarlac's keep, or maybe the High Tower of Sarlac. I don't exactly remember what I'm gonna, like, what it's called, but I think I'm gonna stick to the latter name while naming this. Anyhow, this is essentially what Carl's entire journey has led up to, and we are here to defeat Sarlac, as simple as that. So, with that being said, let's go and get to it. Blackthorne has infiltrated my domain. Weaken him as best you can and see to it that he finds his way here. I will deal with him myself. Oh, pretty arrogant, aren't you? And he points his finger in command. Okay, first level is interesting. It's difficult but and long, but it's interesting. I'm only a servant. Have you come to free us? I need to find Sarlac. He's in the High Tower. I wish you good luck. Freedom by death. Thank you, friend. It's challenging in just the right ways, and it has, like, a lot of variety. I'm still confounded about how to clear the last area, though. That was probably premature of me. That was my bad. So these guys are equipped with the same gun that we have. So, meaning that instead of doing 1 point of damage, they're doing 2 points of damage. Which more or less negates the entire... raise that we got to our health. We effectively have half health in this section. For Sarlac's Keep, I mean. Oh no. Now I need to take this gun out as well. Fine. Have it deal with him. There's a rock team right here. This new one takes many more shots, so you might want to conserve your ammo. As in, watch out. Don't hurt me, thank you. Time to use this, just so that we can get up there, then we'll have to come back and fetch it again. Time to hide. Turn and hide again. Equip my weapon and hide again. Nice. Cool. Part with the Androthi. Take this bomb. Thank you, friend. I like how he calls other people friends. But yeah. Okay, time for a long jump. Careful not to mess this up. Turn and hide, come on. Equip our weapon and hide. Wait for the gap between his shots and use that as your opportunity to shoot him. Right then. We can actually do like a broad jump right here. So this is where we have to go. And unfortunately, well, I haven't tried the other thing yet. Let me go ahead and try that. Yeah. Well, I don't think this... that was Facebook. So, we now need to go ahead and grab the bridge key from them and jump across this gap using a well-timed launch up before this gate closes, so that we can use it in the next section up ahead. My brain isn't draining right now, being why I did that stupid mistake. I feel like I've played this same level for far too long now. Too slow. Playing it without sight for the most part, mostly relying on the sounds, because as it turns out, as humans we have faster auditory reflexes than visual reflexes. Our brains take longer to process the images that our eyes can see, so if the game is giving you sound cues, use them. Close your eyes during combat, at least for this game I mean. I think there's this blind guy who won like the National Street Fighter competition or something. Yeah. So that's pretty much it. If the game has like tons of encoded sound for you to use, go ahead and use it. Okay, so this is phase one. Pull out your gun because you need it against this rock monster right here. These guys always roll towards you, which gets pretty annoying when they're super close to you. Don't hurt me! You just had to, didn't you? Motherfucker. Okay, so for the record, this level is not over yet. But I did chance upon something interesting up ahead. There's nothing here except for another elevator. I honestly don't know how to get down there, to be honest. Okay. Too slow. Done. Now I've got only one enemy to deal with, which is nice. I could use the health, as much health as I can get. So you can go bolder with your strategies. pun, no pun intended. But the issue with going bolder is that you tend to lose more health. That guy said. And so are you. This guy's a bully. You want to hide as soon as you get up there. Lest he molest you. He can knock you off, but for the record. For extra damage. Now, up ahead, these guys are a little crafty. They try to get you with a low drone attack, thinking that maybe, you know what, this guy doesn't know how to shoot below his own waist. Well, guess what? Kyle is a fabled mercenary who knows far more than you think he does. Okay. Now, the guy told me to wait right here. If the enemy is right beneath me or on top of me. Wait for him to move before I essentially... well, try to engage him. But he seemingly has already spotted me and doesn't really want to move. He wants to stick to his advantageous position. And I, for one, do not want to be stuck in the midst. But I do not think I have but any other choice in the matter. So, I know my target right now. It's the guy on the left. Thankfully, he's also the one who's shooting later. Almost dead. Come on. Your turn now. So the good thing about the guy on the left is that he drops a health potion. Bad thing is, we need to remain alive long enough to actually use it. Oh wait, this is just an iron key. I'm surprised this guy did not actually drop any, well, wasps. I guess that was the last wasp that he used. Now, as soon as you walk through this section, you'll get a heal potion. So pick it up, keep it ready. You might need it soon enough. Just saying. Excuse me there. Again. I really like the ambience, the ambiance in this level. I don't know why people like to say it that way, but yeah, I do like the ambiance in this level. I want to learn how to get up there to that guy. So, you don't need to worry about anything being up here. Because there's nothing much up here, to be honest. But what I would like to know is how I can manage to jump this gap right here. Seems impossible to me, but apparently it's possible. I'll just drop down for now. And over here we're gonna go ahead and use a bridge key to talk to this guy. He'll give us a levitator. I took him out. You will need this levitator, Pat. Thank you, friend. Now, the previous time around I tried doing a broad jump to get across the gap that I just showed you guys, but actually that's not what I wanted to do. I want to get this right here. Now, the issue is I don't have any more firebombs because I just used one of them. So, yeah, sad that it has to be that way, but I will have to resort to having my hit points troubled, and this is Andromeda right here. Time to between the shots. Cool. Now, this gate opens up, allowing you to go inside and essentially use a levitator right here. I think it's right here. But before that, I would definitely like to consume that. What the? So this time around, as it turns out, this guy can actually... Yeah, I'm just gonna tank that hit. Better than trying to take that guy out. I'll just wait for this thing to... Come on then. Like, who deployed you here, son? Whoever it was a genius, don't get me wrong, but who the hell deployed you here? What were they thinking? Alright, that took a lot of life out from me. Time to hide. Oh, that's how you get there. Combine your items to reach the elevator by the power supply. Hmm. Interesting. Is essentially what this guy says. Turn and hide. That was very foolish of me. Oh, he's dead. Like I say, I close my eyes when I'm in encounters, so that well, I don't exactly die. So that I have an edge. I utilize my auditory reflex, which is for any given human, much faster than the visual reflex. So if you're ever surprised by how, so that trap actually deploys this machine gun right on top of my head. You can see like a tiny green pixel. But yeah, so I guess when they talk about combining things, they're mostly talking about probably using this as well, I think. And this levitator pad as well. Ah, that makes sense. I would just like to take a bit of a breather though, because I need to get a little bit away from that as it explodes. I would hate to stay right there. Thank you. I was about to say, can we please use that? Yeah. Turns out you can't use a gadget when you're right next to. Oh no, my friend died! Oh no! Oh no! I'm hoping this is the end of the level. Seems to be. Yes, it is. This guy's not gonna come over to you, so he's restricted to that area right there. So you can just shoot away without hesitation. Same goes for the next guy up ahead. These guys are averse to elevators, so might as well go and do that. First off, we're gonna go towards the left. Shoot this guy. Hide. Cool. There's like a deceptive little gap between the shots. Fuck you, laughing pig. Come on. Good. Now, the reason we need to come here is essentially to flip the switch. We can miss this jump. Yeah, if you miss it, you just end up on the elevator instead. Now, this jump we cannot miss. That was a sloppy jump, but this game actually gave us the leeway and the victory. Better equip a gun, because up ahead, we're gonna have to fight this guy on his turf. Smoothly done. Use the repositioning tactic there. Takes them a while to know where you went. Once you've hidden. Like, once they're hidden, they lose track of you. Now, this thing is both a throw switch and a trap. So you better treat it with a little bit of respect. Go back upstairs. Jump across the gap. Pull out your gun, because you will need to destroy that. Now, at this point, we can go downstairs. Talk to our friend here. He'll give us a potion, and we can take this elevator back upstairs. I don't know what that guy downstairs gives us though, but yeah, I would like to find out. Now we're gonna ignore the switch for now, because we first need to fight this guy. I'm gonna bait him to come towards me, so that I can shoot him. If you stand close to them, you're essentially baiting them to, you know, come close to you. Now, I wanna try seeing what the other guy is on about. The one downstairs that we saw previously. And the only way to get to him is with the elevator up there. I honestly don't know what he does. Or what he wants to do, really. But yeah, taking him out is pretty easy. You don't really need to destroy those weeds there. And he's not going to be able to shoot you because of his timing and the timing of the shows. He's a pretty easy prey, essentially. Oh, that's a bridge key, right? I totally forgot why we need to kill him. Turns out it's for a... I took a deep there. I miss watching Rat. He was pretty much the inspiration for me to actually start a Let's Play channel. I saw him playing and I was like, well, if this guy could do it, so can I. I mean, I mean no disrespect to him, but you get the point, right? He's not exactly the best Let's Player. Like, the videos that I used to watch before I saw him playing were always perfect to the point of, you know, being practically esports. Like, right next to speedrun was how perfect they actually were. So when I came across Rat, I was like, holy shit, you actually don't need to be that perfect. And I was like, alright, let's give this a shot then. Yeah, why do you take so long to jump to this one? My god. Well, at least that's one problem less. Okay, hide again here. With a ledge this narrow, there's not really much option for you to jump. So, yeah, you better take what you can get. Probably should not have healed there, but oh well. Whatever works, I suppose. Too slow, excuse me there. Too slow again. But yeah, so as I was saying, Rat, he makes mistakes and shows you that even the Let's Player is human, that it's alright to make mistakes. So that is pretty much what I liked about his playthroughs. Pretty much what inspired me to start my own playthrough channel. The fact that, you know, you don't exactly have to be perfect with everything that you do. And you should pretty much take that advice to heart as well. Start your own playthrough channel if you want to. I think this key will help you. Please take it. Thank you, friend. It does help us up ahead. Now, if you guys can hear some kind of beeping in the background, it's my power backup and it's about to die. This piece has been lacking energy since the morning. I'm gonna keep the bridge key with me. Right in that slot. Now, up next is where we might have a few issues. If we jump straight down here, we'll actually end up with the wrong set of friends there, which we don't want, so. Hide. Excuse me there. Safely done. Let me just hang from here. I'll try to eliminate the beeping in post, but I can offer no guarantees for it. Ran towards the elevator there. Yeah, so this guy does not come onto the elevator either, so you can safely hide away. Like, you don't need to hide. You're safe here. This is a safe space. And I think this guy dropped something. Oh, just a firebomb. I think this guy dropped something, I said after seeing him drop something. And it turned out to be just a firebomb. So this is where we abandon the... Should have taken the shots there. Eliminated. Alright. Up ahead is another section with a rock beast. But I want to get this rock beast alongside these little plants. So to that effect, I'll wait until he gets here before I bomb this area. Fire away! Hide. Just give me a moment there. This next stage is... I don't know what to call it. It's bad, is basically what it is. Yeah, I tried. I tried, that's all I can say. This is where I fumbled the last time around. Fine. Trading the health point to get that working. Too slow. Come on. That was way too many health points traded. Come on. I don't think there are any more enemies here, but yeah, there aren't. At least it gives you some room to stand. Okay, this is the farthest I've been. Alright. Now this level actually has just more dangerous platforming sections, and that's about it. From whatever I can tell about this section here. It's not particularly difficult, just that the platforming sections are a little dangerous as well. Yeah, I'm gonna hang right here until that thing starts moving away again. Jump. Cool. Hide. Well, that also works, I suppose. Lost only one health point in the process, avoided the turret that I needed to avoid. Jump across here. This guy's a bully. I'll wait for him to come back before I go up and hide again. Hide. One shot and hide. That's my strategy. Otherwise, this guy's gonna start rolling towards us again. And that's not gonna be good for anybody. Yeah, I was just hiding there so that I don't get caught up in the explosion. And we need to get here. Hide immediately. Because this thing there is not connected to any door. That is a bridge key. And we need to get it. So, yeah, we need to hide here. Oops. I tend to forget all the keybinds whenever I'm playing this game. It's like this guy can only has like a limited how do I put this? Horizontal movement ability. He can't really get past a certain point. Maybe I should go to the other side instead. I feel like I should be able to just do broad jump. Yeah, I can. Oh, that's where I use that. Okay, that's cool. I need a key for that place over there, which I don't have. That was bad. I need to focus. Come on. Yep, that's better. I need a health potion now. Or we need to fight very strategically, essentially. Yeah, there's nothing down there, actually. I mean, I haven't checked, per se, but I did not exactly see much down there, is what I'm trying to say. Excuse me. Time to hide. Go over here, because this guy can't cross the ladder. And we're gonna exploit that fact to essentially kill this guy. Now we need to go to the other end and do this little puzzle. This guy probably, yeah, he gives us a key. So as it turns out, a running step is two normal walking steps. We can't get up there just yet, we'll probably need like a levitator or something. But for now we have this key which we can use. And in the same view, I'll take the bridge key back as well. I don't know what's down there because I actually have not gone been down there yet. Just give me a second there. Sorry about that. I sort of remembered that I need to retain my snap streak. And accordingly, I was sending snaps to my friends. So we can just go down here. We don't need to get to the ladder over there. We can use it to climb up now. I wonder if there's any place that we can visit to our right over there, because there seems to be a gap. Maybe there is some place for us to go. Apparently not. At any rate, here is where we can use the key. And this is where I died last time, because the spider bot more or less hide. Thank you. Yeah. The bot hit me from behind, essentially, and killed me. I don't know what I used there, but my key still... I have managed to retain the key for some odd reason. Okay, and that is something that I would definitely like to avoid. That is a drone. Now, there's no way for me to get up there right now, so I'll just skip back. I wonder what I'm supposed to use the drone for. Because I can't get up any of these sides. So I think I'm gonna have to figure this one out. Come on then. Hide. Okay, that was bad, but at least I did not fall off. As they say. Maybe I can use the drone against these guys, but I actually do not want to waste all that ammo, so I'll just go ahead and do that instead. Try using this levitator pad to reach high places. Thank you, friend. Pretty much what I was looking for, actually. Let's blow those up. Let's try going to the left and seeing what awaits us further. Just a rock beast. And a path of us. I would definitely like to climb down that ladder up there. To our left. Or rather climb down there to get whatever those things are. Yeah, so if this guy decides to explode right on top of you, you're gonna be in a world of hurt. So before I get anywhere near that place, I'm just gonna use this levitator to get to the different pieces that I wanted to get to. I think the first one was... yeah, we need to take this ladder up first. We don't need to particularly, but yeah, like that is the order that I choose to go in. I think the appropriate solution was to use, how do I put it, the wasp bombs to take those things down there, but I've never actually seen wasp bombs being advocated for that purpose, so I'll just leave the use of wasp bombs for now. I'll just hang right here. I'll be hanging. Good? Good. Alright. Once he starts transforming, he will roll towards you very quickly, so yeah, better to be cautious. Let me go ahead and equip an empty slot so that I don't accidentally choose something I'm not supposed to. Now, this seems like an entirely different way to go, so before I get there, let me go ahead and clear out the other liberty to section. Like, the other section where I need the liberty to. I'll come back here later. And by that I mean this section right here. Worst part about this section is that it also has like one of those goblins, so yeah, we need to be careful. Yeah, better. Down here. Roger. Good. To the left here, use the bridge key to go upstairs. Or just get across. I feel like we could have done like a running jump to get across as well, but it's okay. If we had the option of keeping the bridge key with us, might as well go and do that. So I do believe this is where we need to use the levitator pad. I'll wait around right here. Hide. I'm just shooting whatever I get an opportunity to shoot at this point, is all. Take that, bitch. Got hurt by your own friend there. Too slow. Oh, you're almost dead now. Ooh. Do you give me something, though? It's another key, that's good. Sometimes you retain the keys in this game. I don't know why it happens, but it happens. Sometimes you just retain the keys. And yeah, by all rights I was supposed to have used up that key, but I ended up retaining it. I just quickly want to check if there's something. Actually, there's not. I want to check if there's something to our right, but there actually is nothing to our right there. Farther stuff come, let's hope I don't slip up and I get a... levitator of sorts. Not levitator, I get like a health potion of sorts before going forward. Alright, let's go. Pools of lava. Fire flowing down from pipes. Pretty, careful there. Luckily, you don't lose any health points for dropping on your ass like that. Excuse me. So, yeah, we need an elevator call switch for this next section. And I have a sneaking suspicion that we'll get that soon. I'll wait for that thing to pass. There's seemingly a path inside. I'll hide, as I should be, from that thing. You got it twice. And you've got only yourself to blame for that. I could not shoot you because of the spider helping you out there. It did not die. Thankfully. Too slow. You're dead. I just want to quickly check if there's something down here. Oh, there's a hover bomb there. That's interesting. And a fire bomb. And a health potion that I will definitely use. So, this is what I was talking about. Like, some of these sections have... these invisible areas where... you can't really tell what's going on ahead or what lies over on the other side, but there's something there. Okay, so we need to climb up here and I'll go from the other side instead of this side. Question is, once I go down there, how do I get back up? I guess we're gonna have to figure that out on our own. Now then, this guy here. Probably should have taken the shot. Although I feel like this is an optional encounter. Not anymore though, because this guy's now occupied the space next to the one where I need to head. And he's gonna hit me. There's no way further up. Hi there. You're gonna die soon. How does it feel to be on the brink of death? How rude, you're dropping nothing. I could kind of check what's on the other side. Nothing much. Getting up there though is probably going to be a hassle, but I think this elevator call switch will provide some kind of solution. Pretty sure I'm gonna take some fall damage if I decide to drop from that side, but I honestly don't see any other solution. I guess that's one way to do things. I'm guessing that is the elevator that we need to take, the one down there. Yep. That was very lucky. Yeah, I purposefully walked into that because Alright, let's head down. Oh, we have a key. That's nice. Let us go ahead and use this. So the key should disappear, like in this instance. But it does not. That is not always the case. That does not always happen, for whatever reason. Hide. Come on. So I've figured out the way to shoot backwards, but it's too slow to capitalize on during combat anyway. Not as revolutionary as these guys touted it to be. Should have held it for longer. He would have been dead if that were the case. I see. I'll try normally first, and then I'll try rushing. I don't think I need to rush anymore because I have safely crossed this threshold. Thank you for waiting for me. Now let's convene this meeting. Too slow. So there's nothing up there, I feel like, but just a little check. This is the farthest that I've come thus far, and I honestly do not want to jinx it. Excuse me there. So, I do have a bridge key. Pretty sure that the way to get it back is up there somehow? I don't know. Oh, okay. So, it was probably a good decision on my part to not use the boss bomb. Needlessly. And in the end though, we still do need to get up there. So hanging down here is not really going to tell me what I need to go and get. Let's hope this does not hurt me. It did not, good. Now we shall need to jump the gap to actually call the elevator over there. Let me just check if we can get the elevator. Nah, we can't actually. Once we actually take the call switch out, there's no actual way to get back to it. Like, get further into this level. I don't know why that thing is there, but we can't reach it. So I guess we're gonna have to do it like this. I think I can jump the gap. Time to call the elevator down. Is there anything to our left? Nothing. Cool. Time to go upstairs then, the only way forward. Why am I putting up with this game again? Ah yes, because I like it. For a change, I genuinely do like it. And we got steamrolled twice. Thank you for exploding away from me. This section is frustrating. It's long, it requires you to tank hits, and it throws every possible permutation and combination of enemy known to the developers at you. A shot across the horizon. Well, wasn't that lovely? Just because I pressed the wrong button. Oh well. Why does this level have to be so long? Of course. I don't think I'm making it this run through, but yeah. So apparently, if you ever get stuck, you don't need to commit suicide. I'm sort of confused as to how I did not fall off, but really? Son, really? Would you mind giving me some space there? Would you mind moving away? Or are you just gonna stand there like a bloody oaf? Why don't you turn around? Thank you. Next hit, you're going down. Fuck you. You've already put me down to like 3 health points right at the beginning. No, seriously, fuck you. I'm just gonna hold on this key because I'm feeling lazy. Now, what I've discovered recently is that you do not need to tank the hit from this guy. You can just jump across like this. I've been tanking the hit from that guy all this while. Safe. You're dead now. Oh, you're dead now. So basically, these gates open at every 5 seconds. So if you want to get across, start running at the 4th second and you should be good. Don't you dare move towards me. I've already been pushed off by your kind way more than I'd like to count. I warned you not to. Safe. Because if I had taken another step forward, this guy would have gotten me. Too quick. Too quick. I was being too quick is what my fault was. Now, Yeah, I just want to quickly pick this up and hide. Hide again. Come on. Can I jump across without dying? I wonder. I can. Interesting. Turn around, please. Thank you. Let me hide. 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 Okay, I'm gonna need to use this now. Which is sad. with these guys you want to be a little delayed in the timing, not exactly match the rhythm, be just a little dragging, just a hair. With the orcs though, you want to be on time, on rhythm. So the first one of these guys is going to give us a nothing, just tell us the traitors has come, because probably because of the Andromeda that we killed upstairs was trapping them down here. And yeah, try using this levitator pad to reach our places. Thank you, friend. This is what we have come here for. And I don't know if you guys saw it down there or not, but the only way for us to go down is to actually hang on to the ledge that's down there. In that regard, we need to hide. Pull out a gun and hide again. Two hits on you. Nice. Come on. So I'm not speaking much, but I'm just trying to focus a little on this game because I've been constantly losing a ton of health. And yeah, I don't want to do that anymore, essentially. Once you're clear of this, draw out your gun because, yeah, because this. Two spider bots and two of these rolling thingies. Could have shot a little while longer, but oh well. That explosion was wasted, could have taken out one of the spider bots, but oh well, it's fine. I guess I'll let them all roll away. Slowly. Genteelly. Well then. Looks like we're stuck with our spider bots, huh? I'll just let them pass. These spider bots are not a nuisance. The ones that are a nuisance are up ahead. And we need to take them out the old-fashioned way. We also need to tank one hit point there. Pretty sure what my issue is that it's a skill issue, but yeah. Yeah, I sort of lost track of my character there. So we need to trigger a switch up there and come back running up here. So just to clear my path, I'm going to take out all the spider bots. Turn around. These two are going to sap most of my health. Unless I'm very careful and selective with my shots. I'm going to ignore this for now. I can pick it up later. But for now, I'm just going to go here and tank a hit. Know the way to do it. Now, there's a key in that sack there, but it's on the way back, so I'm just going to leave it be. That was not how it's supposed to be done. So as soon as you start going up, you need to start firing so that you can actually get that generator down there. We need to try and figure out which one is still shooting when the first one hides. Two hits on you. Cool. You're dead. No, it's a more traditional battle, but it's good. I like traditional battles. Not this asymmetric warfare. Let these guys make us fight. This guy's not gonna start rolling at you. Unless you, like, shoot at him too much. Three shots and he will start rolling at you, so better hide when that happens. And better shoot at him while he's away from you, so that he does not explode in your face. Surprisingly, this is the farthest I've come without losing like a whole chunk of my life. We actually need to go back there and retrieve the levitator because... Hide. The game doesn't really give you a lot of time to react, that's for certain. Jump up there, come through, and you're golden. Now we just need to go ahead and pick up the levitator. Oh, right. That was my bad. Luckily though, once you hear the door closing, you still do have like a bit of time. It's not like it's the end of the world or anything. But yeah, let me just hide away from these things. Play it safe, no need to be an action hero and jump over them. Like one. Alright. Now we're going to this level and... ooh, the battles up ahead are brutal, let me tell you that. We do not need to retrieve any of these. In fact, we will be leaving them behind. Cool. Turn and hide. Draw and hide. I'm just trying to get a sense of his timing. So, my apologies if I'm not commentating enough because I am trying to focus. I've been dying way too much in this section right here, in this particular level. It's long and my god, are the battles difficult. This next section is easy, not difficult at all. The section after that though, that is, it's holy bonkers. Holy bazookas is what it is. Kindly pardon my attempts and freezes, as might be evident to some of you folks, I'm not exactly English. As in, it's not my first language. Motherfucker did not give me long enough break. I'll draw and hide. Draw and hide. Come on. All right. One hit. Two hits. You hit. He's dead. Which makes this a more traditional battle, which I like. But this actually isn't the worst of it, because up ahead we're gonna fight not one but two enemies. And boy. They will have there'll be like one of these rolling thingies, like Stone Beast, an Andromeda Dog, and an Orc. Yeah, so the first time around I actually fell down there quite a lot. I do not want to step on that just yet because I want to clear the section up ahead first. Which is going to be probably the biggest challenge of my life. I'm just waiting for the star storyline. I don't know who to hit first. At least I have health. He's dead. It's far better, actually. I prefer it this way. Come on then. It's almost a one-on-one battle now. Come on. One more hit. You're dead. Thank you. Now I need to be ready to hide as soon as I hit this button because I don't know what it's gonna do. Not as much. I had a feeling. Okay, that's Galadriel. What are you doing here, Galadriel? Finally made it through. Holy shit. Greetings, Kyle. The time for you to face Sarlac has come. If you fail, our people will never be free. If you succeed, peace will return to Tul. I understand, I will not fail. Then this will make you even stronger. I bid you farewell and good luck. I guess we're gonna need all the help we can get, huh? Farewell, old friend. Really? Ah yes, for now. At last we meet, Valp. Now I shall destroy you, just like I destroyed your weakling father, said Sarlac. I have spent my entire life but preparing for this moment, demon. You will not catch me off guard as you did my father. You are about to witness true strength. I'm going to crush you and spit on your bones, boy. I think not. The time has come for my father to be avenged. Your skull will make a fine trophy. Give me your worst monster. Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, I shall. Okay. Wrong answer. Hide. Wrong answer for wrong answer is what we've been giving Sarlac. One shot. Disappear. Run. One shot. Unequipped. Hide. Okay, I think I'm getting a hang of this. One shot, remember? One shot. Oh, we defeated him! We defeated Sarlac! Holy hell, it didn't take long actually. I hope this is not a second phase or anything. We defeated him! We defeated Sarlac with 2 hit points remaining. Amazing. With the evil Lord Sarlac defeated, the Dark Soul no longer posed a threat to the Androthi people. Oh wait, let me not click on anything. I didn't want to skip the final cutscenes, like I did with the starting. As heir to the throne of Vlaros, Blackthorne was declared leader of the Androthi nation. Ooh. Stepped on a skull there, actually. In following years, Sarlac's remaining forces were destroyed and a new Stonefist was constructed. Stonefist, huh? The castle. As king, Blackthorne came to be respected by his friends and feared by his enemies. I can see that there's somebody sitting there serving him wine. He ruled justly and fairly, and he ruled with honor. Interesting to know, he has Sarlac hanging on his wall there. Game design, Blizzard Entertainment. I guess that those are the credits. Yeah, those are the credits. So this game was actually more on the difficult side, but it was fucking enjoyable. I mean, holy hell, I don't remember the last time I've had so much fun playing a game. Even though this was like, it was like the perfect amount of challenging, and the level of challenge just kept increasing with every consecutive level. And that's essentially the most beautiful part about it. And it is just such a beautifully, beautifully designed game that I just can't imagine how they managed to design such a beautiful game all the way back in 1994. Because that's mind-blowing to me, to be honest. Because I honestly thought that they would never be able to do that. But holy hell, I mean, of course, they did make an arena as well. I'm guessing this is, we're back to the main menu right here. And let's eat last. Eat at last. Take this potion, brother. That's a nice scene. Anyhow, so as I was saying, wait, is he coming back to Earth? I hope not. That would suck. Post-credits scene there. I'm guessing the GIs are still searching for him. So the story as it goes is apparently the fact that... Oh no. Well, he's going to get pounded hard. there's no shortage of military forces on Earth. But yeah, I guess that was a setup for one of those... a sequel, essentially. And with that, we have reached the end of Blackthorne. Holy hell, this was a fun game. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around, not only until the end of this long-ass video, I'm pretty sure, but also the very end of this entire playthrough. So, yeah. Oh, man, this game is... I mean, it started off as nostalgic, and it just became so much fun as it went on. I'd actually never went past the mine area, and it got progressively more and more difficult and more challenging, but... Holy hell, this is pretty much the first time that I've played something like this to the finish, to be honest. And I loved it. I loved every single bit of it. Despite the short amount of content, replaying this game was a little frustrating from time to time. That is the only flaw that I can find from this. But the rest of it was, well, holy shit, it's such a beautifully designed game. Towards the end though, they did have a few, maybe, they took the challenge up a little too far when they actually made the, you know, the enemies there, I mean, the permutations of enemies. They were literally using maths to find out new permutations that they could use for the enemies. That I feel like might have gone a little bit too far, but yeah, apart from that, I honestly cannot find a single flaw with this game. Perhaps the only other flaw that I could say is that maybe they should have made the checkpoints a little more frequent, so as to make it a little less frustrating. But holy hell, this was such a fun game. And well, if this game has a sequel, I would love to play it. I'm surprised that Blizzard actually made something as amazing, considering that the only other title that I'm exposed to that belongs to them, I mean, would be Call of Duty. Not Call of Duty, actually, that's Activision Treyarch, but which one was it again? Call of Duty Warzone? Yeah, Warzone. So, I mean, everything about this game is so amazing, even the controls, the animation, the preciseness, it's like the importance of timing, and it's just brilliant. This game is brilliant. I mean, honestly, personal favorite of mine, to be honest. I'm gonna recommend this game to as many people as I can, to be honest. And in the end though, it's like, well, I had lots of fun playing it. I'll just leave it at that, honestly. So yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around to the end. Until next time, I've got no idea what I'm gonna play, but whatever it is, whenever it is, see you then. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings. Oh, and the soundtrack is amazing. So, just wanted to add that as well.